نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي اللهم فقهنا في الدين رب زدني علما اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا رزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه اللهم أرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه آمين ثم آمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Surah An-Nisa, verse 159. وَإِن مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لِيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكُونُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا And there is none from the people of the scripture but that he will surely believe in Jesus before his death. And on the day of resurrection, he will be against them a witness. In this verse 159 of Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning another concept regarding Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. And here Allah is saying that from all the people of book, from all the people of scripture, they will believe in him before his death. Now, what does this mean? We know then when he was given prophethood, then only a few people, as I mentioned yesterday, only a few people believed in him. And then he was raised to heaven. So when will this all happen? That all the people will believe in him? And what about his death? He was raised. When will his death happen? And when will all the people of scripture believe in him? This verse and some other similar verses in Quran indirectly provide the evidence of descent of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam before the day of resurrection. And this is one of the major signs of the day of resurrection. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has in detail given us and elaborated the signs of resurrection. As we know that the previous prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they used to give the information and signs and news about the prophets who were to come after them. And not only did they inform or they give about the news of the subsequently coming prophets, they also used to take covenant from his followers that they will believe in the prophet who will come later on. They will believe in him and they will help him, they will support him, and they will also believe in the teachings which will be taught and revealed to him. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, since is the last messenger and the last prophet, Khatimun Nabiyyin, as Allah says in Quran, so there will be no messenger and no prophet after him. So what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the period after him till resurrection are the signs of resurrection. And in detail, the words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has to the finest and to the minutest of details elaborated the various signs. And these signs have been listed in two categories. The first is the minor signs, which will come first, and then are the major signs, which will follow the minor signs. Now, talking about the minor signs, two of the minor signs, they appeared in the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These being Number one, Hazrat Sahal bin Sa'ad radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they have both reported in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, both my prophethood and resurrection are like this. And the transmitters explained that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed his two fingers, the index finger and the middle fingers. He joined them and showed them to the companions to make them understand and realize how close to the prophethood of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was resurrection. And the second minor sign is mentioned in Quran in Surah Qamar, where Allah says, اِقْتَرَبَتِ السَّاعَةُ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرُ. The day, which day? The day of resurrection is close and the moon split. So the splitting of the moon was the second sign of the minor sign, which came out in the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, regarding these minor signs, these will be in the form of seditions. There will be appearance of seditions, and these have been mentioned in all the books of hadith, especially the six books of hadith. They come by the name of, in the book of Kitabul Fitan. The Kitabul Fitan narrates all these events of the major and the minor signs. Now, how will these seditions appear? Hazrat Usama bin Zaid radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, did you see what I saw? The companion said, no. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I see the seditions falling on your houses like raindrops. So all these will be, they've been given the example of raindrops, because raindrops fall generally for everyone. They are common for all, and moreover, they are numerous. So this will be the manner the seditions will appear. Similarly, Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates in Ibn Majah, the Prophet said, before resurrection, nothing will be left in the world except seditions and troubles. Miseries, crises, trouble, this will all that there will be before resurrection. Hazrat Zubair bin Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates in Bukhari, the Prophet said, be patient, such a time is approaching when every coming day will be worse than the previous day till you see the sustainer. And how intense these seditions would be. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet said, resurrection will not occur till a person who passes by a grave will say to his companion, I wish I was in his place. That is, the deceased person who was in the grave, the living person would want and desire to be in his place. That is, desire to death, to escape these intense seditions would be the desire of the people of that time. They will be so intense and so severe. Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports, Prophet said, after your time, he was addressing the companions and he was mentioning a time after the time of the companions. After your time, the period of patience will start. During this period, patience will be as difficult as to keep a burning charcoal in your hand. At that time, the reward of a patient believer will be equal to that of 50 men. The companion said, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will they be 15 men among us or among them? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, among you. So this will be the intensity to stay steadfast in the path of Allah and to be patient in the obedience of Allah will be so extremely difficult that the person who will stay patient and steadfast and obedient will be rewarded like 50 times as much as the companions were. Hazrat Huzaifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a time will come when people will desire the appearance of Dajjal. Why? Companions asked, why will it be so? Prophet ﷺ said, it will be due to the severity and the intensity of the seditions. That is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has advised all of us, and those specially who will be present in the time of these severe and intense sedition, is as it is reported in Bukhari that he said, "Ya ibadullahi fasbutu, O people, O believers of Allah, keep steadfast." Keep steadfast. And this was the instruction of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for this period of seditions and for the period of fitan. What will be the minor signs in this period? I will go on narrating different words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to highlight all the happenings and all the signs. Zahabul ilm, there will be perishing of knowledge. Hazrat Abu Musa radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet ﷺ said, before resurrection, a time will come when illiteracy will prevail. Illiteracy and ignorance will prevail, and religious knowledge will perish, and haraj will become common. Companions asked, what is meant by haraj? He said, bloodshed. So, because of illiteracy and ignorance, there will be bloodshed, and people will go about plundering and looting and murdering people around them. And how will this ignorance and illiteracy prevail? And in other words, Prophet ﷺ informed that knowledge will perish. Knowledge will perish because of the death of the learned and the true scholars. And scholars will become extinct. People will ask about the issues of religion from the ignorant and illiterate people, and they will misguide, and they will be misguided themselves. The next is aqooqul walidain, disobedience of the parents. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Ibn Majah that there was a long list of many things, but here in this report, Prophet ﷺ said that a woman will give birth to her master. What does that mean? That like a slave woman fears her master, likewise mothers will fear their children. Meaning the children will be so disobedient, and they will be so harsh, and they will misbehave and mistreat their mothers, that the mothers will be afraid, and they will fear the misconduct and the misbehavior and the harshness of their children. And then Prophet ﷺ has narrated the next thing before as signs of the minor signs will be rafa'ul amana. There will be extinction of trust. Hazrat Huzaifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet ﷺ said, a thorough honest man, a person who is honest down to the core, a thorough honest man will sleep at night, and honesty will be drawn from his heart, and only a black spot will remain behind. The next day he will sleep, and the remaining will also be drawn out, and only a slight sign like a blister will remain behind. And near resurrection, people will do business, but they will be void of honesty, so much so that an honest man will be presented just as an example. That is, people will say that such and such man in such and such family is honest. So generally, everybody will be dishonest, and the person who is honest will be quoted, will be specially mentioned. And people will say that such and such person is very wise and very brave, but does not have any faith and is dishonest. Then there will be shahadat az-zur. There will be false evidences. There will be falsehood, and it will dominate all form of truth. As Tariq ibn Shahab radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Musnad Ahmad, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, false evidence will become common and true evidence will be concealed. Similarly, Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood reports in Musnad Ahmad that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that before the day of resurrection, false evidence and concealing of true evidence will become a common practice. It will be norm in the society. And then Ziaul Ahad, that is the breach of promises, breach of breaking of the pledge or promises. Hazrat Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu ta'ala and reports in Ibn Majah that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, promise and trust will mingle with each other. That is, people will not be careful about any one of them. People will become corrupt. Good and evil deeds will mingle with each other. So no promise, no truth, no honesty, just falsehood and false dealings and dishonest, unfair dealings will be prevalent. Qatiyatul Raham, breaking connections with the relatives of kin. Hazrat Tariq ibn Shahab radiallahu ta'ala who reports in Musnad Ahmad that people will say salam only to acquaintances. Business will flourish so much that wives will be obliged to assist their husbands. And this is actually what we are seeing and the current state of affairs. People will break relations with kith and kin. And then another report, Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Musnad Ahmad, that people will just say salam to acquaintances and they will break the connections with their relatives, and this will be very common. That people won't even feel upset about breaking relationships of kin. Then there will be all forms of unfair dealings prevalent. There will be injustice, there will be dishonesty, and there will be unfair dealings. Hazrat Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Musnad Ahmad that Prophet said, resurrection will not occur until immodesty and foul speaking will become common. Connections with relatives will be broken, and dishonest will be called honest, and honest will be called or labeled as a dishonest. So the normal ethics and the normal mode of the mode of ethics of Islam and the teachings of Islam, the manners will be totally like 180 degrees opposite to that. Then there will be ashur, selfishness. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet said, time will pass rapidly and people will become selfish, and selfishness will find place in hearts. This has also been reported in Muslim. And then carrying on with other minor signs, people will try to conceal their age and they will try to look young. As Hazrat Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala who reports in Abu Dawood that Prophet said that in the last period there will be people who will dye their hair black, who will dye their hair with a black color like that of the color of a black pigeon's chest. And then Prophet said, such people will not even smell the scent of paradise. So dyeing up the hair with black dyes, this will also be a minor sign of the day of resurrection. And then inefficient people will be rulers. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala who mentions in Bukhari that Prophet said, when the government is entrusted to inefficient people, then wait for the doomsday. And then the love of the world. The love of the world will be so magnified for all the people, as Hazrat Sa'ban radiallahu ta'ala and who relates in Bukhari, that Prophet was sitting with his companions and he said that in a very near future, the non-believing nations will attack on you. That is, the anti-Muslim powers and the non-Muslims, they will attack the Muslims. And what will they do? They will invite one another like a person is invited for a feast. The companions immediately asked, that will we be short in number? Prophet said, no. Rather, you will be in a colossal number, but your condition will be like the foam on the surface of water. And Allah Almighty will diminish your awe from the hearts of your enemy and replace it into wahan. People asked, what is wahan? And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا وَقَرَاحِيَةُ الْمَوْتِ, love for the world and aversion for death. That the followers of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, rather than being concerned and rather than being caring or careful about the hereafter, they will be concerned and they will be just bothered about the world. They will be loving the world and the worldly life and the worldly wealth and the riches only. And they will be averted to death. They will not be desirous of shahada, of jihad. Then there will be prevalence of polytheism, there will be free play of all forms of innovations, there will be abundance of wealth, deceit, bloodshed, and then there will be abundance of song and musical instruments. As Hazrat Sahal bin Sa'ad radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when musical instruments and female singers will grow in abundance, and wine will be given a religious sanction, wait for the resurrection. Similarly, Hazrat Abu Malik Ashari radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Ibn Majah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that some of my followers will drink wine under some other label, and they will patronize music and female singers. They will sing, Allah will make the earth engulf them and give some of them the shape and form of monkeys and swines. Allahumma la taj'alna minhum. But I think you will be continuously realizing that all these signs, all these major signs, minor signs, which have been indicated in the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are prevalent. We can see all of them. Then Hadith says that there will be abundance of adultery, zina, and khamr, wine. Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu has reported in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the signs of resurrection are that knowledge will diminish, illiteracy will prevail, adultery will be common. Obviously, when there's no knowledge of Quran and Hadith, and when people will become ignorant of the teachings of Islam, then obviously the third thing, adultery will be common. Drinking wine will find free play. And then Hazrat Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu has reported in Muslim similar words that there will be diminishing of knowledge, abundance of illiteracy and drinking of wine and open adultery. These are all the signs of resurrection. How common this will be, Hazrat Abu Amir Al-Ashri radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, some of my followers will declare silk, adultery, rape, wine and music as lawful. And this is exactly what is happening in the current period. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has also explained the sedition of unlawful earnings. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that he said, a time will come when one will not mind whether he earns money by lawful means or by unlawful means. That is, unlawful earning will not upset people and they will not just be bothered about being careful about it. And then there will be the sedition of women, of the vulgarity and immorality of women. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu has reported in Muslim that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that before resurrection, what will be? The women will be naked despite wearing dresses. The dresses would be so tight fitting, the dresses would be so revealing, so transparent, that although they will be wearing dresses, but still they would be naked. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam subsequently said, they will be seducing and they will be seduced, and their heads, they will be like the humps, they will be like the haunches of camel, and such women will not even smell the scent of paradise, where the scent of paradise will be smelled from a long distance. And then there will be following of the Jews and the Christians, like reported by Hazrat Abu Huraira in Bukhari, that Prophet ﷺ said, resurrection will not occur until my followers adopt the mannerism of the former people. And how will that be? Prophet said, "You people will follow the footprints of the former nations. If they walk a span, you will also walk a span. If they walk a cubit, you will also walk the same. If they walk two cubits, you will also walk the same. And if they enter the hole of an iguana, you will also do the same. And if any of them has sexual relationship or any of them rapes his mother, you will also do the same." Astaghfirullah Rabbi. Astaghfirullah Rabbi. And this is all what is very, very much prevalent in the days of today. And then there will be a quick passage of time. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports that Prophet said, "Resurrection will not occur until time will start passing quickly. A year will be equal to a month will be equal to a week will pass like a day will pass like an hour, and an hour will feel like the burning of dry leaves of date. Quickly passing time." Takarabu zama. So this will be the basic minor signs, and I will definitely request you to notice around yourselves, and you will agree with me that all these signs, they are prevalent in abundance. They are all of these signs, the minor signs, they are prevalent in a colossal abundance. Now, after this will come the major signs. And regarding the major signs, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that when the first major sign, that one, the first of the signs will appear, then the rest will keep on following. The rest of the signs will keep on following so quickly, just like when the thread of a string is cut, or as it breaks, then the pearls go on falling consecutively. That is, it is just for the first sign, major sign to appear, and then it will trigger the sequence of events, and then one after the other, rapidly, consecutively, one after the other, they will keep on coming in a very fast manner. So one of the major signs is the emergence of Imam Mehdi. And as mentioned by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the emergence of Imam Mehdi will be in the month of Muharram. We do learn from certain weak narrations that some words of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which do not come up to the level of Sahih Ahadith, but come up to the level of Hasan Hadith, that it has been reported that before that month of Muharram, there will be certain events. And these certain events have been related to certain specific months. That is, for number one, in the month of Ramadan, the Ramadan preceding the Muharram in which Imam Mehdi will appear, in that Ramadan, there will be solar and lunar eclipses. There will be plenty of comets, there will be many earthquakes, and the earthquakes and volcanic eruptions under the water below the oceans, this will cause water currents in the oceans, and hence there will be many floods. These are the few happenings which have been related for the month of Ramadan. And then in the month of Shawwal, there will be the big war. This big war has been mentioned in many narrations of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This big war is the Armageddon. The Armageddon. The Armageddon is the big war which has been reported by Hazrat Zee Mekhbir radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Abu Dawood. That Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that you what? The followers, the Muslims, the followers of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the Muslims, you will reconcile with the Christians of Rome. And you will with them fight a third enemy and you will conquer them. You will conquer the third enemy. And then the Muslims and the Christians will collect the booty and they will come back after the conquest and they will pitch their tents on a rocky field. And they will be in They will be like rejoicing and they will be happy about the conquer that a Christian leader will raise the cross and will announce that the cross has conquered. That is what the person will say, is that the conquest was basically because of the efforts and because of the struggle of the Christians. And at this, a Muslim leader will not happen to like this, because the Muslims and the Christians were fighting together. And so the victory was common to both. So Prophet said, at this, one of the Muslims will slap him. And there will be a fight between the Muslims and the Christians. And then the Romans will, Romans will breach the pact. And then they will gather a Christian war against the Muslim forces. Now, what will be this Christian war? Hazrat Auf bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala, and who has reported in Ibn Majah, the Prophet said, there will be peace and pact between you and the Romans, as I have already narrated in the previous words. And then the Romans will back out because of all which has been related in the previous words of the Prophet. Then the Romans will back out, and then they will bring an army of 80 flags. That is 80 countries against, 80 Christian countries against the Muslims. And under every flag, there will be a troop of 12,000 soldiers. So roughly like 90,000, a troop of 96,000 or almost 1 lakh, they will be attacking that Muslim country, which made reconciliation with the Christians to attack a third enemy. So this will be the big war, which has been mentioned as the Armageddon. And this will be, by many narrations, has been mentioned in the month of Shawwal. Then after that, in Zikat, Hadith mentions that there will be fighting among the tribes of Arabs. And in Zilhaj, this fighting will increase to the extent that there will be bloodshed and killing in Mina. And finally, the ruler of Arabs will die. The king of the ruler of Arabs will die. And then there will be fights in the royal family for the succession, for the selection of the successor. And when this fight will be going on in the royal family of Arabs, then will be the emergence of Imam Mahdi. About Imam Mahdi, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given a very elaborate description. Imam Mahdi, as reported by Hazrat Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Tirmidhi, that Prophet said, the world will not end until a man who will be one of my descendants will rule over the Arabs, and his name will be after my name. Similarly, Hazrat Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anhu has reported in Abu Dawud, that Prophet said, Imam Mahdi will be from my family and from the descendants of Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. And similarly reported by Hazrat Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Abu Dawood is that Prophet said that resurrection will not happen until Allah will appoint a man from my family or from my descendants as a caliph, and whose name will be after my name, and whose father's name and whose mother's name will also be after my mother and father's name. So generally, Prophet ﷺ's father's name and the father's name of Imam Mahdi has been explained to be the same. Imam Mahdi has been reported to be about 35 to 40 years of age. He will have a middle height, and he will have clear wheatish complexion with thick black hair and a very broad forehead with bright shining eyes. And he will be slightly stammering in his speech, and he will slap his thigh when he will be making conversation, and his rule will last for 7 years. And then after that, how will he be recognized also comes from the word of the Prophet ﷺ, as reported by Hazrat Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha, that there will be 7 scholars. Seven scholars from all over the Ummah, from the different states of Ummah, they will not be related or they will not be known to each other, but they will proceed towards Makkah because the Ummah will be in a state of terrible plight. And these scholars will go to Makkah to look for and to find Hazrat Imam Mahdi. And they will see Imam Mahdi in the terrace of Khana Kaaba, and he will be holding to the curtains of or the covers of Khana Kaaba and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease out all the persecutions and difficult conditions of the Muslim Ummah. They will recognize Imam Mahdi and they will convey this recognition to Imam Mahdi, who himself would not be aware of the fact that he is to be the Imam. And they will convince him and they will urge him to announce about his imamat. But he would refuse taking such a big responsibility. And then he will go to Medina and they will follow him and pursue him to Medina. And then he will come back to Makkah and people of Medina will inform these scholars that he's left for Makkah, and they will come back and get to him in Makkah and they will urge him and convince him. And then they will tell him that if he does not announce and if he does not declare his emergence, then the blood of the Ummah, he will be accountable for. He will be answerable for that. And so he will agree to what they will suggest, and then people will vow for him between the black stone and the standing place of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. Other words of hadith clearly explain that at the initial vowing of Imam Mahdi, there will be just 303 people, the same number as were present in the Ghazwa-i Badr, in the Battle of Badr. And then after that, there will be a happening that there will be a troop from Syria and it will march forward to attack Makkah. Why Makkah? To finish off this whole a group who had vowed on Imam Malik, on Imam Mahdi. And then this troop will reach the place of Baida, as mentioned in this hadith. They will reach Baida, and earth by the orders of Allah will swallow them. This will be the final indication and the final highlighting sign of the truth of the emergence of Imam Mahdi. And all the scholars of the Muslim Ummah from all over the world, Muslim world, they will then identify Imam Mahdi as the truth. And then they will come as groups to accept and to help and to follow him. And from here, then he will be leading different expeditions and he will be taking huge armies with him, and Mu'mineen over and the believer from all over the Muslim Ummah, they will come and join him for jihad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised him success and conquest wherever he will go, wherever he will go. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also promised that all these mujahideen who will join the army and the troops of Imam Mahdi, they will be rewarded with Jannah. And the troops or the army of Imam Mahdi, they will move in different paths to help the oppressed Muslims of Ummah. And wherever they will direct to, they will be awarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will be blessed with conquest, and they will be, inshallah, all the people who will be associated with this jihad, they will be promised with Jannah. Now, after the whole of this sequence which will be going, one of the biggest conquest will be, which has been mentioned in detail to the minutest of details by the words of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will be the conquest of Constantinople. The conquest of Constantinople will be a conquest by Imam Mahdi and his troops, and the Muslims will be thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will be happy for the conquest that emerged at the same time. it will be announced that Dajjal has emerged. The emergence of Masih Dajjal will be announced at that point. And then from there, immediately, Imam Mehdi will send a few people to investigate about the condition. And then Imam Mehdi will himself also take his expedition for finishing off the whole of the seditions which have been launched by Dajjal. And then what about the Dajjal? Prophet has in detail talked about all the signs of the Dajjal. The Dajjal was also called as the Antichrist, will be tall, fair, with bright shining eye and one eye like a swollen grape, and between the two eyes on the forehead, kafara, kafir will be written, non-believer, kafir will be written. And Prophet ﷺ said that only Muslims will be able to, believers will be able to read this. And then he will have thick black hair in the front, but he will be bald at the back. He will be a tyrant, and he will persecute, and he will torture, and he will punish the Muslims of the Ummah. And he will travel in the earth, and he will travel all over the earth and the world. And he will with him have a Jannah, and he will with him carry a hell. And he will go to different places of the world, different countries, different nations, different cities he will land up. And then there he will scare the people. He will threat them. He will show them his hell, and he will threaten them that if they do not abide by him, if they do not obey to him, then he will subject them to the torments of his hell. Prophet has clearly narrated that all those people who will not get scared of his hell, of the torments of his hell, and they will stay steadfast in the obedience of Allah, and they will refuse to obey the Dajjal, then they who will not be fearing his hell will be made or will be rewarded of Jannah. And then he will show the people his Jannah. He will try to tempt the people of the world, showing his created Jannah. But those who will resist the temptations of his Jannah and will make the destination, their final destination, as the Jannah which Allah has promised, and will not be tempted or will not be seduced by his Jannah, then they will be rewarded as Jannah. And those who will get tempted by his Jannah, then they will be subjected to the torments of hell fire. And then he will control the rains, and he will control the duration of the day and the night, and he will be torturing the Muslim Ummah. He will enter all the cities of the world except Makkah and Medina. He will keep his camp, and he will set his camp close to Medina. And because of his coming there, Prophet ﷺ said and mentioned that the land of Medina will vibrate like an earthquake, will badly vibrate, and all the hypocrites having a weak faith, they will get scared. They will get scared of his punishment, and they will go and join the Dajjal. These are the people for whom Prophet ﷺ mentions hell, the punishment of hell. But those who will be strong in belief and faith, and they will stay steadfast, and they will not fear the Dajjal, then they will stay back in Medina, and they will be rewarded with Jannah. And all the emergence of the Dajjal will be ended by the descent of Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam. The descent of Hazrat Isa has been also mentioned indirectly in various verses of Quran, as we are discussing in this verse 159 of Surah An-Nisa. There are other verses also. But how will Hazrat Isa alayhi salam descend, and what will be the position and which part of the world, and what will be his attire and appearance? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been reported to explain, as Hazrat Abu Huraira narrates in Abu Dawood, that there will be no prophet between me and Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. He will descend from heaven. So when you see him, identify him with these signs. He will have a middle stature, fair color, and a fair complexion, wearing yellow clothes. And hair as if drops of water are about to fall. And he will be accompanied with two angels on his left and on his right, and his hands will be on the shoulders of the angels, and he will descend. Descend where? On the eastern part of Damascus, on the white minaret mosque. And then he will do what? He will fight against the people to make them embrace Islam. These are the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will break the cross. He will kill the swine. He will abolish the tax. And Allah will erase all religions in his time. And he will kill the one-eyed Dajjal. And his rule will last till 40 years. And then he will die. And Muslims will offer his funeral prayer. Similarly, in other words reported by Hazrat Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Isa alayhi will descend on the earth. He will marry, he will have children, he will live for 40 years, and then he will die, and he will be buried beside me, my grave, beside me and my grave. And on the day of resurrection, I and Isa alayhi salam will be resurrected together amidst Abu Bakr and Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So this is how he will descend. Now once Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will descend, then at the time the Muslims would have gathered for the congregational prayers, and the Imam would be there to lead the Muslims for the prayer, and he will see Hazrat Isa alayhi salam coming and proceeding, and he will step back. He will step back, and the gesture would be to show what? That he, the Imam of Muslims, would be requesting the Prophet Isa alayhi salam to lead the salam. But Hazrat Isa alayhi salam would make a sign with his hand to ask the Imam of the Muslims to lead the salah, and he himself, the Prophet Isa alayhi salam himself, will offer the salah behind the Muslim Imam. And this will be a clear-cut indication that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will be following and will be a follower of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will be a Muslim. So all the Christians will accept Islam, and Christianity will be abolished, and the cross will be broken. Now after abolishing the Christianity, after abolishing Christianity, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, accompanied with Imam Mahdi, will lead an expedition. They will pursue the Dajjal or the Antichrist, and then Hazrat Isa alayhi salam would kill the Dajjal. And hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reports that then Hazrat Isa alayhi salam would show all the troops and all his people the sword which will be stained with the blood of the Antichrist or the Dajjal. And after this, there will be a total killing of all the Jews. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, to the extent that all the trees and even the leaves of the trees will call out, and they will inform that there is a Jew hiding behind me. So all the Jews will be killed, and so Judaism will also be finished and abolished. The only religion will remain will be the religion brought and taught by Muhammad sallallahu wasallam, and Islam will prevail. Islam will prevail now, and then there will be the emergence. The next major sign will be the emergence of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. This has been mentioned in the Quran, Surah Anbiya, verse 96. Allah says, "Hatta iza futihat ya'juj wa ma'juj wa hum min kulli hadabin yansilun." Until when Ya'juj and Ma'juj are let loose and they hasten out of every mount. So this is what is mentioned in the Quran. But Prophet ﷺ has in detail explained about the Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Regarding the appearance of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, Hazrat Ibn Harmala radiallahu ta'ala and who reports in Musnad Ahmad that Prophet ﷺ said about the Ya'juj and Ma'juj that they will have flat faces, small eyes, reddish black hair, and they will be short statured, and they will come rushing from every hilly place, and their faces will be flabby like leather sheets. So this will be about the appearance of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. And then in the words reported by Hazrat Nawas bin Saman radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Muslim, Prophet ﷺ said, after this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the Ya'juj and Ma'juj loose. They will rush. And they will rush out from every hill, and then they will come and they will drink off all the water. They will drink off all the water, and they will finish off all the sources and all the treasures and reservoirs of food. And then they will say, "We have killed the people on the earth. Now let us kill the people of heaven." So they will throw their arrows towards the sky, and Allah will return these arrows stained with blood. And they will think that they've also killed the people of heavens. And then in the meantime, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and his companions, they will be besieged in the mountain of Tur, and eatables will be exhausted. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to finish off this Ya'juj and Ma'juj. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pour the torment on Ya'juj and Ma'juj, and Allah will create insects in their necks, and all of them will die at once. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and his companions, they will come out from the mountain Tur, but then the land will be full of the dead bodies of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, not an inch left. And there would be offensive and stinking odor and from all the places on the earth. And Isa alayhi salam and his companions, they will again pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to clean the earth. And Allah will send birds. They will have long necks like those of camels, and the birds will pick up the dead bodies and they will throw them wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order rains, and there will be such a heavy rain that it will reach every house and every tent, and it will wash away the earth and will make the earth clean as a garden again. And then Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will live, will establish Islam, and then he will die. And after Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will die, then all the Muslims on the earth will also meet death. And how will this be? There will be blowing of a breeze. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she reports in Muslim that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that when Allah will send a fair breeze, and with it every person having the least of belief in his heart will die, and he who will not have the least of belief will survive. The remaining people will turn to their ancestral religion, that is the religion of polytheism. So now do you understand what will happen is that after Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will expire, then this fair breeze which will blow, this will cause all the believers to have a minor ailment, like Prophet ﷺ mentioned in another words, they will have a low-grade fever, like a light sort of an influenza they will suffer with, and all the believers will die. Because the day of the resurrection will be just and just. The torments of the day of the resurrection has just been specified for the non-believers. So all the believers on the earth, they will die, and only the non-believers and the polytheists will now remain on the earth, and people will stop talking about and remembering Allah and His orders. And then after this, there will be Al-Khusufu Salasa, three big
incidences of the earth engulfing, as Hazrat Huzaifa bin Usayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates in Muslim, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned about these three khasuf: an engulf in the west, an engulf of the earth in the east, an engulf of the earth in the island of Arabia. And then there will be, after that, there will be talu ash-shamsi min maghribiha, the sun will rise from the west. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Muslim that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, resurrection will not occur until the sun rises in the west. And when it will rise in the west, all people will express belief, because this will be like the final signs of resurrection now. All the people will express belief, but then their belief will not benefit them a bit. In other words, Hazrat Abu Zar Ghaffari radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Oh Abu Zar, do you know where the sun goes?" He said, "Prophet, and his Allah know better." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "On reaching the west, it," that is the sun, "seeks permission to prostrate, and it is granted permission. Then it sets. A time will come when it will be ordered to turn from where it has come. So it will rise in the west." So this will be the day before resurrection. The sun will rise from the west. Then there will be an emission of smoke, and then emergence, Khuruj Dabatul Arz, emergence of the beast from the earth, as has been mentioned in Quran, verse 82 of Surah An-Naml. Allah says, وَإِذَا ذَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِّنَ الْأَرْضِ تُكَلِّمُهُمْ أَنَّ النَّاسَ كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا لَا يُوقِنُونَ. And when the word is fulfilled concerning them, we shall bring forth a beast of the earth to speak unto them, because mankind had not faith in our revelations. So now this period, when all the believers have died, and just the non-believers and the polytheists had remained on the earth, and people had stopped talking and mentioning and remembering Allah and His commandments, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by His order, will cause the earth to burst, and a beast, Dabbatul Arz, a beast will emerge from the earth, and the beast will then talk. People would have stopped talking about Allah and stopped remembrance of Allah, and this beast will then remind them of the teachings and of the names of Allah. What people had stopped doing, then this beast will do. And after this, there will be the devastations of Makkah and Medina, and no Hajj, no Umrah, no Tawaf, nothing will be done. And how will be the Haram and how will be the Kaaba demolished? Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that how and whom will it be demolished? That a Negro with two thin calves will demolish the Kaaba. So Khana Kaaba will be demolished, and this will be the ultimate thing. And then the final thing, Khuruj an-Nar, what will be the appearance of a fire. Hazrat Salim bin Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu has reported in Tirmidhi that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, before resurrection, that is when all these minor signs and when all these major signs have appeared and Kaaba has been demolished, then what will happen? A fire will appear from Hazremoth, or the sea of Hazremoth, and it will gather the people towards the field of resurrection. So this will be the final major sign, and then there will be sur. Nufiqa fi sur. They will be blown in the sur, and then there will be qiyama. Iza zulzilatil arzu zilzalaha wa akhrajatil arzu asqalaha wa qalil insanu ma laha. يوم إذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها. This will be then the day of Qiyamah, followed by the day of resurrection, where all the living beings will be resurrected. The prophets, the messengers, the righteous, the believers, the non-believers, and the sequence will then continue. And the journey will then proceed. So these are the predictions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam Mahdi and Christ, they will kill the Dajjal or the Antichrist, and then Islam will be prevalent and Islam will be the dominant or the only religion on the earth. But the concept of Christians is, and what they are waiting for is that Christ will descend. They are looking forward to the descent of Christ. And they think and they believe and imagine that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, after his descent, will kill the Antichrist. And then what will happen is that everybody will be converted into Christianity, and Christianity will become the only and only religion on the earth. So this is what the Christians believe. So you see what they believe: descent of the Christ and the presence of the Christ, Antichrist, and the killing of the Antichrist. It's all the same what Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said. But they don't actually believe in Imam Mahdi. And they don't actually believe that Christianity will be abolished and Judaism will be abolished and the only religion will be the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what is the concept of the Jews is that there will be emergence of the Dajjal, whom they call as the Antichrist. And they believe that Antichrist will finish off Christianity, will kill all the Christians, will persecute and kill all the Muslims. So the followers of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be finished, and the followers of Hazrat Isa alaihi salam and the Christians will be finished. And according to them, what they are waiting and looking for too is that the Antichrist will then make Judaism the only religion on the earth. And because of these concepts and ideologies, currently, till today, Jews and Christians, they are apparently united against the Muslims. And it is just because of that, that at the patronization of the Christian world, the Jews who have been, because of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were gathered all over the earth and they did not have a state of their own. There was no Jewish republic for the Jews because of the punishment given to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is mentioned in Quran, and we'll be going through it inshallah soon. They were scattered all over the world, and the Christians, they gathered the Jews, and it was under the patronization of the Christian world that a Jewish state of Israel was created and then was accepted by the United Nations and by the different countries of the world. The purpose of this creation of this Jewish state was to persecute or to oppress and to torture the Muslims and to weaken the Muslim states. And what is the plan of this? What is the plan of this united Christian and Jew world is? A few points I would want to highlight. The creation of Israel, that has been done. The second point, their agenda, the second point on their agenda is creation of a greater Israel. And that has been achieved also. The creation of the greater Israel has also been done. The third point on their agenda is demolition of the Mosque of Aqsa. And why would they want to do that? Because they want to reconstruct the third temple. And why would they want to reconstruct the third temple? Because the Jews want to reconstruct the third temple for a reception of Antichrist. And the Christians want to reconstruct the third temple for the reception of the Christ. And moreover, for the reception of both. Both the sects, both the religion, both the followers are doing what? They plan to reconstruct the third temple after the demolition of Mosque of Aqsa. And then they will here in the third temple, they plan to place the throne of David for the Christ or for their Antichrist. The throne of David, which is already with them. It is in their custody. It is in the custody of the Christian world. London, the Church of Westminster Abbey, they have the throne of David there. And when, according to their plan, after the Greater Israel, after the demolition of Mosque of Aqsa, after their construction, reconstruction of the third temple, they will place the throne of David in the third temple for the reception of what they plan, the Christ or the Antichrist. This is what they believe. And this is what they are united now. But when the project will be completed, they will also split. This is what they believe. But we, by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, have been told the whole and the actual truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, save us. Save us from these seditions. Save us from the signs of these resurrections. And save us from the seditions of the Dajjal. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after offering his salah, used to say these words very frequently. Remember them, memorize them, and remember to recite these verses, these words very frequently. Allahumma inni a'uzu bika. Allahumma inni a'uzu bika min fitnatil masih ad-dajjal. This was seeking Allah's protection from Masih Dajjal or the Antichrist. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, save all of us, help all of us, guide all of us, protect all of us, and bless all of us with the best of belief and faith. Bless all of us with the steadfastness in belief and faith. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين آمين ثم آمين. Today we've covered the verse 59, inshallah. Tomorrow we'll be starting from verse 160 and covering up the rest of the verses of Surah An-Nisa, inshallah. And tomorrow will be our last session. We will cover these verses in the initial, like about 20 minutes to 25 minutes. And I shall be there in brief talking about the concept of usury in Islam and how much forbidden is the unlawful earnings. And then we will wind up. After winding up Surah An-Nisa, inshallah ta'ala, we will be making dua. And at the completion of the commentary of Surah An-Nisa, we will be making our dua with all of you raising hands, inshallah. With all of you, inshallah, raising hands. And I would request you to invite as many as you can. It will be the 27th of Ramadan. We will be in a state of Ramadan. We will be in a gathering of remembrance of Allah. And we will be in a condition that we would have gone through the message of the verses of Allah after these 27 days, when we will spread our hands and we will beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all our needs, for all what we desire, for all what we wish, for all we will seek forgiveness for, inshallah ta'ala, the Subhan Rabb will definitely answer the prayers, will definitely, inshallah ta'ala, by the mercy and by the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will be reaching His throne. The doors of the heavens will, inshallah ta'ala, open for them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will receive the dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept all the prayers, and they will be answered and they will be accepted. So those whom you love and those whom you want that their du'as be accepted, please invite them to the session of tomorrow. Inshallah, our Urdu session is also completing tomorrow, and we will be having a dua for Urdu session also tomorrow morning. That is from 10:30 till 1 in the morning. We will have our lecture. I will be delivering my Urdu discussion, and inshallah, that will also be followed by a dua. And now this English session, inshallah, in the evening, as our routine broadcasts online, will be followed by a dua. So please join us either in the morning session or in the evening session. And I will also request all of you that if you have anything which you want me to pray for during the session of dua, then please you can inbox us, you can send us all these written duas, and inshallah I will be keeping all of them in my mind. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Fi amanillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.